The veena has occupied a place of high honor from the most ancient days among India's musical instruments. It has rested in the lap of Saraswati, the goddess of learning and the arts. Innumerable are the references to the veena in our classical texts, and copious its representations in the arts. The veena has been the trusted companion of a long line of composers and artists down the centuries, especially in the South. Among the foremost exponents of the veena in our time, and the most lyrical of them all, is V. Doraiswamy Iyengar of Mysore, who was born in 1920 and passed away in 1997. Inheritor of the style of the maestro Sheshana, Doraiswamy Iyengar was celebrated for the sureness and delicacy of his touch and the way in which imagination and emotional richness shone through the classical discipline of his art. He looked every inch an artist, with his chiseled features bringing to mind a Chola bronze, his dreamy eyes and his graceful gestures. He won high acclaim within the country and abroad and was laden with honors. The award of the Central Sangeet Natak Academy, the degree of the Doctor of Letters of the Mysore University, the presidentship of the Madras Music Academy's annual conference, and the title of Sangeeta Kalanidhi that goes with it.
The Music Academy cherishes its association with Sangeeta Kalanidhi Veena Doraiswamy Iyengar. He is one of the regular in attendance in all our annual conferences. and it was a privilege for us to honor him in 1985 with the title of Sangeetha Kalanidhi. Besides being a traditional Mysore-style veena player, he was a perfect gentleman, and we always remember him with love and affection.
Padma Bhushan from the President of our Republic. But few men were more modest than he was. He dressed with simple good taste and shunned flamboyance and show on the platform or in his lifestyle. Fellow musicians were forthcoming in acknowledging Duraswamy Iyengar's rare qualities. The doyen of Carnatic music, the nonagenarian Chemmangudi Srinivasaiah, had high regard for the purity of Duraswamy Iyengar's playing and the beauty of his thanams. He often recalled the admirable work he did as producer of music of All India Radio Bangalore, where singers like Balamurali Krishna and Srirangam Gopalaratnam rendered compositions set to music by him. Pandit Ravi Shankar admired him for his fantastic mastery over the veena strings and his childlike simplicity. The veteran Kannada poet P.T. Narasimhachar hailed him as a Kalatapasvi, a spiritual seeker in the realm of art. It was an unusual saga of success for a boy born in a nondescript village called Doddagaddavanahalli of his mother's parental home in the Hasan district of Karnataka. It was an impoverished family that had no tradition of music. Three people played a part in the transformation of this rural child into a modern master. His father, his chosen guru, and the Maharaja of Mysore. The father was Venkatesh Iyengar, son of an orthodox Brahmin who owned and tilled a small patch of land in the nearby village Madihalli. Early in life, Venkatesh Iyengar dreamt the dream of music and decided to devote his life to it. He moved to Mysore, a city known for palaces and elegant mansions and tree-lined avenues. It was a byword for light and learning. Silk and sandalwood. Jasmine and ivory. And above all, for Sanskrit and music. This Bidaram Krishnappa Ram Mandir, some 7 decades old, has always been a hallowed spot for musicians and music lovers. Thank you. A succession of Maharajas of Mysore had been great patrons of music. The luminaries who lived in Mysore when Venkatesh Iyengar moved there included Veena Sheshanna, Veena Subbanna, Bidaram Krishnappa, Muthaiya Bhagavathar, Vasudevachar, Venkatagiriyappa, T. Chaudhaya, to name only a few. Venkatesh Iyengar had the good fortune to be accepted as a disciple by Venkatagiriyappa, who headed the Palace Ensemble. He made such good progress that at a comparatively young age, he was appointed as one of the court musicians, Asthan Vidwans. He even gave lessons to the Maharaja, Krishnaraja Vadiyar IV, in flute for some months. Venkatesh Iyengar had less ambition for himself than for his children, especially his firstborn son, Doraiswamy. At his pleading, Doraiswamy was taken by Venkatagiriyappa as a disciple at the tender age of 7. Venkatagiriyappa, himself a disciple of the great Sheshanna, was a genius as a teacher and kindness and generosity personified. Although he dressed in the grand manner of the court, he was totally free of the besetting sins of the court life, namely pettiness and envy. He poured out freely from the storehouse of his affection and musical scholarship and trained a whole galaxy of musical stars in Mysore without expecting a rupee as fee or reward. He detected Doraiswamy's potential long before the young lad had become aware of it himself and nurtured it with limitless love and patience. The boy was more interested in juvenile pursuits like tree climbing and playing hopscotch in the lane. But Venkatagiriyappa told him, "You are born for the Veena, young man." So persistent and persuasive was he that by the time he was 12 or 13, a passion for music took possession of Doraiswamy. As he recalled later, "Without my realizing it, the Veena had permeated the whole of my life. I didn't want to be parted from it, even for a moment." The pupil had to play a sequence again and again until he got it right. It should not sound as if someone was beating the Veena with a raw banana, the guru would say in jest. "Relax the muscles of your face," he would implore. The Veena should sound as though it was singing on its own, not as if notes were being forced out of it, he would explain. "Hold the Veena as the mother tigress holds its young cub, firmly, but with loving gentleness," he would advise, echoing Sheshanna's words. Sheshanna had passed away when Doraiswamy Iyengar was just 5, but his legacy was there for him to partake of. Young Doraiswamy's extraordinary talent came to the notice of the leading lights of music in Mysore and the South. It naturally reached the ears of the Maharaja, who asked Venkatagiriyappa to arrange a demonstration. Doraiswamy was fitted out in a newly stitched black long coat and white trousers and a cap on the head. Doraiswamy's voice had not yet broken. He was only 13. He was taken to the court along with the other 2 students, both girls. One of them, now an octogenarian, the 3 young artists played the Veena for half an hour, singing at the same time. At the end of the recital, the Maharaja turned to Venkatagiriyappa and remarked, "You should bring him up well." The young musicians were sent home with presents of fruits and flowers and 50 silver rupees each, no small sum in the 30s. Besides learning music, Duraswamy also went to school for his regular education. A few days later, a message went to his school with word that he was wanted at the palace. He was ushered into the presence of the senior musicians who made up the palace ensemble. From then on, he was to be one of them, a palace musician at 13. At the ruler's behest, he acquired good knowledge of Hindustani and Western music as well. Venkatagiriyappa had also done so and had composed several passages in Hindustani style. Duraswamy in later years loved to play jugalbandi with Hindustani masters such as the renowned Mallikarjuna Mansoor and Amjad Ali Khan. Duraswamy had still to pursue his formal education along with his music. He plodded through the Maharaja's high school, the intermediate college, and the Maharaja's college in Mysore. He found it hard to pass his examinations at first attempt. His teachers in college included reputed scholars and literary men, because of whom he came to realize the importance of a broad humanistic culture. They too had a soft corner for him because of his stature as a musician. The BA hurdle was at last crossed in 1945. A photograph shows him with two persons who made him a great musician and a good man. His father, his guru. The fourth person in the group is a fellow musician and classmate. 30 years later, he obtained another degree unasked, a D.Litt, from his alma mater as one of its most eminent alumni. A year prior to his graduation, a major event occurred in Duraswamy Iyengar's life, his marriage to Srimati Sharadamma, who proved to be a true helpmate to him for the rest of his life. The couple were blessed with three sons and a daughter. For the next half a century, it was music, music, and music for Duraswamy Iyengar.
Thank you.
Beginning with his life being featured in the national program of All India Radio, he rose fast in public esteem and remained at the top by dint of both his innate genius and his incessant sadhana.
ನಾನು ದೊರಸ್ವಾಮಯ್ಯಂಗಾರರು ಸುಮಾರು 10-15 ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಕಾಲ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದರು ಆಕಾಶವಾಣಿಯೊಳಗೆ. ಅವಾಗ ಅವರು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದರು, ನಾನು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ.
ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ರೇಡಿಯೋ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಲೋರ್. ಅಮಂಗ್ ದಿ ನೋಟಬಲ್ ಅಚೀವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಿ ಟಿ ನರಸಿಂಹಾಚಾರ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಗೋಕುಲ ನಿರ್ಗಮನ ಅಂಡ್ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ಪಟ್ಟಾಭಿಷೇಕ. ಬಿಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಕಂಪೋಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ for the AAR orchestra and set to music many compositions of old saints and modern poets.
ವಾದ್ಯವೃಂದ ರಚನೆಗಳು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಸಂಗೀತ ಸಾಮ್ರಾಜ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೊಂದ್ಸಲಿ. ಹೀಗೆ ಅನೇಕ ವಿಧವಾದ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳು ಮಾಡಿ ಆಕಾಶವಾಣಿಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಹೆಸರು ತಂದು ಕೊಟ್ರು.
ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಬಿಲವಿಡ್ ಮೈಸೂರ್, ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಗೇವ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಟು ಹಿಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅರ್ನ್ ದಿ ಲಾಯಲ್ಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕಲೀಗ್ಸ್. He also worked as music director for a couple of films. Passing away of Venkatagiriyappa, Doraswamy Iyengar came to be recognized as the foremost exemplar of the Mysore school of veena playing, which was distinguished for its special meetu or way of plucking the strings and its distinctive gamakas and chittetanas or phrases. Explain, while the Thanjavur school laid stress on the veena players wholly emulating vocal music, the Mysore school believed in giving equal importance to the special character of the veena as well and combining the Vadya Dharma with vocal graces. After all, the Thanams that are sung owe their inspiration to the veena. Specialities of the Mysore tradition is the Panchaveena, the playing of five veenas together. It had been nurtured by the palace and given a new lease by Venkatagiriyappa and then in his turn by Doraswamy Iyengar. He led the Panchaveena team to the Festival of India in Germany. One of his finest compositions was specially created for Panchaveena rendering. Swami Iyengar was unaffected by fame. He had the highest respect for the public, but dealt with audiences on his own terms. He believed that the Veena was better suited for chamber music than for mass audiences. He swam against the current by refusing to attach a contact microphone to his Veena. He maintained that it would distort the subtle blend of microtones, which is the essence of Veena music. He pointed out that Western classical instrumentalists also disapproved of contact microphones. Established rapport with the listeners through his contemplative grace and emotional depth. As he pursued the elusive secret of some movement, he seemed to illustrate in sound what he had once stated in words. The Veena is the God I believe in, but he has withheld so many secrets from me. There have been moments when it looked as though the mystery might be revealed to me at last. But the next moment it is gone, like the will-o'-the-wisp. But I shall continue my search. As music, daily long walks were a passion with Duraswamy Iyengar. He loved to wander lonely as a cloud. Life was kind to him. And he lived as a contented householder in his simple Bangalore house until fate struck to deprive him of his son-in-law in an air crash. He was himself involved in a road accident. With these intimations of mortality, he cut down his public engagements. But even his closest friends little imagined that the end was so near. After a few weeks' illness in 1997, one day he asked for a portrait of Lord Rama to be brought to him in his bed. Along with it, his wife also held before his eyes a small frame containing the pictures of the musical trinity, Tyagaraja, Dikshita and Shama Shastri. He uttered a faint prayer, Janardana, and was gone. A gentle finale to a long, beautiful song. Veenavadana Tattvajna Shrutijati Visharadaha Talajnyascha Prayasena Moksha Margam Sagachati.